We are all aware that plastic is terrible for the environment. It's non-degradable, breaking down into smaller and smaller pieces to become microplastics. It's everywhere in the air, in the ocean, even in our water, threatening every life. There couldn't be anything worse, right? Well, actually, other materials such as paper and cotton are more harmful for the environment according to life cycle assessment. Can you believe that? I couldn't believe that. What is life cycle assessment? Every product goes through some stages from extracting materials, manufacturing, delivering, using, and disposing. And it has environmental impacts associated with all stages of its life cycle. Life cycle assessment is a methodology for assessing those environmental impacts. There are so many environmental factors considered in life cycle assessment. According to Denmark EPA's life cycle assessment of grocery shopping bag, plastic bag has the least impact on environmental factors among paper and cotton bag under the condition of a Denmark waste management system. To provide a better environmental performance than a virgin plastic bag, a paper bag should be reused 41 times. And a conventional cotton bag should be reused 7,100 times. An organic cotton bag should be reused 20,000 times. Also, it should be noted that recycling a plastic bag or a paper bag is worse for the environment than reusing it once as a trash bag than incinerating it. This study was based on Denmark system, so the actual result may vary from a location with different conditions. Furthermore, it is noteworthy that this study didn't account for influential factors such as littering and economic impact. Nevertheless, it is an undeniable truth that any type of bag has an environmental impact. The majority of consumers want to choose eco-friendly material or products, as we do, according to many surveys. But this carrier bag study's results make our choice not straightforward. It's frustrating. The least harmful material, plastic, is making this mess. I want to show you my reusable bag. It's confess time. Wow. I didn't know I had so many bags. I didn't buy any of them. Most of the bags were promotional items from different events. These bags are categorized as an eco-friendly promotional items. So do you think these are eco-friendly even if I have this many and I haven't used most of them for a long time? If you are having many reusable bags like me, or you are collecting eco bag for your fashion item, we should turn our attention from finding eco-friendly material to our behavior. whether it's sustainable or not depends on the way we use it. Without our effort to use materials sustainably, nothing can be eco-friendly. Carrier bags are just the tip of the iceberg. Every product around us, such as food, clothes, furniture, even electronic devices, are made by resources from the earth. A mass-produced product can hardly be eco-friendly. Science tells us we need to reduce the use of materials overall significantly. Humans have been overusing earth resources for a long time. Our current lifestyle makes it difficult for us to live sustainably. Just swapping one material for another while continuing throwaway lifestyle will not solve this problem. As much as we wish, not harming the earth is not easy. We should be more knowledgeable on the environmental impact of what we are consuming and what we are making to make a wise decision in every life and give powerful input to manufacturers to adopt sustainable practice. But for our voices to convey the correct message, we should educate ourselves and be critical consumers. Most of all, we should be aware of industry's wrong and superficial solutions responding to eco-conscious consumers' requests. In many cases, companies are placating eco-conscious consumers' demand by replacing one material with another that claims to be recyclable, bio-based, compostable, to improve their branding and increase sales, but without in-depth analysis of the whole life cycle. Before researching, I wasn't aware of these complex situations. As I learned, I realized that many factors can impact the environment. It is not just the end product I see, also the underlying process from extracting resources, manufacturing, delivering, using, disposing, and even recycling. We should remember that all mass-produced products can hardly be eco-friendly. Let's be creative to live with less consumption and less environmental footprint. Reuse what you already have as much as you can. Refuse to get what you don't need and repurpose to expand the product's life. Let's be critical to regulation, company's business model, or other situation in environment-wise way. And let's research not just material, but the sustainability of the entire process. I will continue researching this matter. Please join with me in this cause. Thank you for watching my video.